So where do you want to begin, Puck?
Be all that you can be. Be the best and the brightest. A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
This is where those of you on meal plan will eat. Welcome, freshmen! Or freshman. Whatever. Come on.
Feed your head. Feed the beast. Feed the children. Feed me Seymour. It's food for thought.
And this is our library, where you can study, do research, meet people. Here is the geography section. Have some American history. Got your world history. Yeah, I have crashers in the social science stacks. Again.
Bigger is better. Too much is not enough. My eyes are bigger than my stomach. You can have it all. Happiness is only a purchase away. He who dies with the most toys wins.
Good morning, sleepyheads.
Housing is a right, not a privilege.
So I told them. But they were in no mood to argue social theory. There is a path in life that is open to all Americans. Work hard, study hard, grow up fast, die young, sacrifice your youth, succeed at all costs. Winners never cheat and cheaters never win. And in the end, your kids and your kids' kids and your kids' kids' kids will follow in the same formation, each generation, scratching and clawing its way to the top of the socioeconomic food chain. But anyone can buy into that.
Now, remember, 50 meters above the forest floor, disposal of your own bodily wastes becomes a daunting task. However, to be an effective...
Anarchy isn't just a theory. It's not something you read about in books. It's a way of life. Some people call it a religion. Bullshit. Religion is something you do one day a week, or one day a year, before getting back to your lazy boy and your big screen, multiplex, 500-channel home entertainment center.
Can we? Please.
Okay, son. But remember, life is just a game. Anarchy is pure, undiluted freedom. It's liberty out of bounds. Have you ever had a dream where you were flying and never wanted to come down? Anarchy is a continuation of that dream. Every day, in every way. It's heroin chic without drugs, orgasms without sex, pleasure without pain. Remember Quebec, D.C., Davos, and Genoa? That's us. You ever hear of the 1999 Battle of Seattle? We brought presidents and heads of states to their knees. We changed the rules of world trade. There were 250,000 of us marching in the streets.
That's right, Lance. Police are estimating the crowd at 70,000.
Okay, so I lied. But you get the point.
People from all over came to join us. Some stayed, some left.
Got some new recruits.
cool. It's not just cool. It's the intersection of life and politics. Activism and action.
We might not know what we're for, but we know what we're against.
Multinationals, conglomerates, the NASDAQ, the destruction of the rainforest, the Nikefication of the world, a Starbucks on every corner, and an SUV in every garage. My older brother sold his soul to the man ages ago. He programs computers for a multinational company in Silicon somewhere and made over $4 million in their IPO. Anarchists don't object to working for freedom. Only their rules are different. Property is theft, deeds are propaganda, destruction is creativity. Only love and sex are commodities.
Afternoon, welcome to Golden Chick. Can I take your order?
Well, that depends on how many times you want to take it today. I was here an hour ago. You took my order. I ordered 9 cheeseburgers, 2 hamburgers, 3 catfish combos, and 2 chicken wings. And this is what I got.
Do you have a receipt?
Do you keep receipts from Golden Chick?
I guess not.
That's Johnny Red, a true believer. A real 60s radical who hung out with Abby Hoffman, dodged the draft, and somewhere in there rode buses with black people back when that was a thing. There's Abby, and that's Johnny.
You ready?
Let's go to it.
And that was Jin, Johnny Red's girlfriend since she was in diapers. They said they were beyond marriage and jealousy, beyond bullshit. They were monogamous and shared everything, including a general disrespect for the basic laws of hygiene.
God, man, how do you afford
It's not a big deal. I mean, it's only 100% cubic zirconia. How about martinis?
A 6 sapphire Bombay gin martinis, please.
Tree.
Okay.
What can I say? It's entertaining. You know, I usually don't pick up hitchhikers, but she had a pair of legs on her that wouldn't quit. Dot, dot, dot.
I never thought it would happen to me, et cetera, et cetera.
I see you're familiar with the genre.
No, 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 not really familiar per se.
I am that girl.
Huh?
The girl in the letters. The one with legs that don't quit. The one with lips that'll leave you dry. The one that'll fuck you 6 ways to Sunday. The one that everyone thinks is bullshit. That's me. Need help taking those to the table?
Wonder where he went.
I don't know.
Karla was a high school dropout whose sexual harassment suit against a gym teacher had turned her off on the American legal system, the American educational system, and American men in general. Her 2 favorite games were home wrecking and musical beds. Now, most people wouldn't call those games. I only do because, as Wittgenstein noted, all games have winners and losers, and in everything Karla did, there were losers and 1 winner. Herself.
I always hated the way the CDs rubbed up against my nuts when I was trying to steal them.
Oh, you know, we were gonna pay for them, man.
Music's a right, it's not a privilege. These are yours, so long as you bring me back something in exchange.
So they're free?
I was Napster before there was an internet, a raver before there was ecstasy, a believer in rhythm before you two were even born. Back in the caveman days when all they had was a spear and a drum, the whole tribe would get together and make this funked up beat, man. Everything was open and free to everybody, you know? And all you had to do was show up.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. Well, if you guys excuse me, late for dinner.
Karla brought Sweeney home from a rave one night where he was the DJ and he never left. Sweeney was a male version of Karla, but without the game playing or anger towards the opposite sex. In fact, Sweeney was nothing like Karla. He loved women and women responded in kind.
Did you know that in Sweden they actually give children the same rights as adults?
That's how all Johnny Red stories started. Like, in Sweden, hookers are legal. In Sweden, there hasn't been a war in 100 years. I wanted to ask him if in Sweden he would shut the fuck up.
There are no rules, but smoking is prohibited.
Yo, G, check these guys out, man. They're from Canada.
You ever wonder about Canada? It's like America, but not really.
And that was Double D, my best friend, my blood brother. D squared stood for Dumb and Dumber. Supposedly, his parents named him David Dwight after the president, proving that intelligence, or lack thereof, is genetic. And out back were the trolls, a bunch of tree-hugging throwbacks Jin adopted after Jerry Garcia died. No one really knew where they came from. We didn't ask them questions, and they never asked much of us. They were peaceful, organic, crunchy types who homeschooled their kids to be peaceful, organic, crunchy types. And we were one big, happy family, slowly but surely devolving back to nature and a purer way of life. Everybody got along and freedom was the name of the game. Until the day Johnny Black arrived.
Dude, what is that? That's a double dribble. Dude, what is that?
That's
man?
A triple dribble, man. What are you gonna do about it?
Hey man, let's just call it a game.
Hey, I'll play. You guys even thought about strategy? Look, every system was made to be broken. They just keep running the same play on you guys. They block you and pass behind you to set up their point, man. You want to get the guy who chucked your friend, then trust me, man.
Just trust me.
All right, here we go.
Nice!
Oh, yeah. Nice shot! Oh. Good boy! Up top! Oh!
Thanks,
man. I'm here.
Great.
Sweeney!
Yeah!
I should have known a guy who called himself Johnny Black would be trouble. I should have known what we were getting into. I shoulda, woulda, coulda. But I didn't.
We at the consumers, where it hurts, where they shop, simultaneously striking a blow for animal rights.
We're all decided then?
Yeah.
Is that all?
Weren't you listening? We're gonna have some serious news coverage.
And then what?
Huh?
Well, how far are you willing to go? Look, we can make some alliances with some like-minded folk and really teach them a lesson. Okay, like I said, every system is made to be broken.
Retribution will come after the revolution.
Besides the Sweden thing, that was Johnny Red's other favorite saying.
Did you hear what I said? There will be time for retribution after...
Yeah, that must have sounded great in 1968. But if you talk to the man in the street this millennium, revolution's not what's on his mind.
Government is good.
The era of big government is over.
What can I get two tickets to the cowboy game?
What are you proposing?
Pure, undiluted, 200-proof, genuine anarchy. See, I'm a nihilist. I don't believe in anything, not even nihilism.
Rebel.
Nihilism? What's that?
Nihilism is a total rejection of established laws and institutions.
Well, that's not what we were about.
Okay, well, what are you about?
Not about rejection.
And we're not about smoking either.
So let me get this straight. No drugs, no technology, and no acts of destruction.
And no cruelty to animals.
Have it your way.
The cops pull you over because your license is expired, but you probably will leave. Just get out of the car.
further. Drive him like that, right?
Hey, where are you from?
You heard a knocking?
Where are you from?
All over. Folks had some trouble with the FBI, so we were always moving.
Well, for a kid who grew up on the lam, you sure speak like an honor student.
Thanks.
How far are you willing to go?
What?
Well, you say you want total freedom. You say you want a new type of world, so I'm just asking, how far are you willing to go?
Oh, that's a complicated question.
No. Don't answer me now. Don't answer me tomorrow. Just think about it.
Dallas. Big D. We like to call it Malice. Malice is where the meat meets the seat, where the buckle meets the Bible Belt, where the South meets the West. The only place worse than Dallas is the suburb of Plano, a place where the first syllable says it all. Dallas is the epicenter of every wacko organization in America. Conveniently located halfway between Waco and Oklahoma City, Big D is ground zero for American anarchy. Lee Harvey Oswald was from Dallas. John Hinckley was from Dallas. Ross Perot is from Dallas. Need I say more?
Into my own hands, my friend.
This is stupid, man. Let's get out of here.
Nobody's stopping you.
Hey! What do you boys think you're doing?
Is there a problem here, sir?
Yeah, there's a problem.
Do that. There was no reason.
Dude, if it wasn't for that fucking guy, we'd have set every single one of those animals free. Leave it to the fucking pig to fuck things up once again.
He wasn't a pig, man. He was a private security guy making minimum wage.
Exactly. He's a $7 an hour rent-a-pig wannabe, man. That's even worse. Look, it's not like we inflicted any serious wounds, okay? That guy's fine.
We?
We.
We.
We. What, are you speaking French now?
After that, I realized, we realized, we had to let Johnny Black be Johnny Black. We were anarchists, remember?
I don't believe in anything, not even nihilism.
See you again.
According to my social calendar, I'll be available never. Does never work for you?
But I...
But. Go home. Your fiance is waiting.
Look, I love you.
What?
Can I say something?
What's the matter this time?
Nothing. Johnny Black.
What about him?
I don't know about him. When he beat up that guard, it was so gratuitous.
He wasn't there, I won't judge.
Of course not. You probably think he's hot.
Excuse me? The day I sleep with Johnny Black is the day I die. Look at those kids. They have any idea how fucked they are. Their troll parents give them every freedom in the world. I mean, they never say no to anything. When they hit puberty, they're gonna have nowhere to go, nothing to rebel against, no barrier to break. They'll already have done it all. They'll be college Republicans into latex and leather, looking for discipline and someone to say no to them.
Are you saying what I think you're saying?
Field trip.
You guys do for fun, huh?
Fun? This is education. This is where we deliver the message to the masses.
We're changing the world one mind at a time.
Anyone have any questions? Yes, you with the girl on your lap.
I was just wondering exactly what it was that Davy Crockett fought and died for.
So, they could taste a little thing we call freedom.
I see.
Any more questions?
Whose freedom?
Excuse me?
Well, he didn't die for his own freedom because there's not much freedom in death. And he didn't die for the Mexicans' freedom because he was trying to kill them. So, whose freedom did he fight and die for?
Sir, you see, the heroes of the Alamo, okay, fought and died for the freedom of all of us who came to Texas after them, okay?
Oh, including the slaves?
Yeah! What about the slaves?
Yeah. As I understand it, the Mexicans weren't allowed to even own property for 100 years.
Yeah, now we're talking. We Latinos, we have always been treated like second-class citizens around here.
Lady's got a point.
Is that what you call freedom?
Yeah!
Right.
Well, it looks like our job is done here.
No, you in the middle. You in the middle. You right there. Just push this, right? You hear my monkey? Where's the monkey? Where's the monkey? Come on, you gotta help me find my monkey.
You know, man, the ladies might like you a little bit better if you were really so desperate.
I'm not desperate.
There is the monkey.
That's desperate.
You found my monkey.
Hey, out your way.
Sweeney had a thing for tourists. And he had to admit that he had a logic.
First of all, you know they're in town looking for a good time. They want to be stimulated. Second of all, they're only gonna be here for a short while. That leaves no time to get to know one another. And third of all, if you're lucky, You're really lucky. They won't speak a word of English.
I, on the other hand, was... What was the word Johnny Black used? Ah, yes. Desperate.
I don't want to be with anybody else.
Hey, girls. What are you doing? Why do you be like that? Which one of you are next?
Decided to move on.
It's up to you.
That's right, it is up to me.
You'll just be fodder for the beast.
And I hope the beast is hungry.
Whatever your inner child tells you, man.
My inner child says move on.
You'll be back. You won't like it on your own.
Where are you going?
I don't know.
Can I come?
Not now.
But...
But what?
You said you'd always be there.
And I will. You know that, right? Right?
You've probably asked yourself when you go to your local corporate coffee hellhole, are these assholes on drugs or just plain stupid? The answer is yes.
I'll have a double decaf latte with extra foam. I said I'll have a double decaf latte with extra foam.
You're pretty.
You mean that? Hello? Is there somebody here who can help me? Anyone?
Would you like to make love?
These things happen. God knows I've had my fair share of lovely ladies come on to me. But you learn how to handle it, son. You'd think a handsome fellow like you would be used to it by now.
Besides the weird, latent homoerotic thing, the boss was a good guy. He gave me a second chance and even hired Double D to help out. For my part, I agreed to do it drug-free. I would only use what they had on the premises.
Can I get a venti mochaccino?
One venti mochaccino!
One venti mochaccino!
Would you like a complimentary shot of espresso? Just 25 cents, payable to the tip jar.
Well, I don't know.
Okay. 10 cents, okay? Whatever you can spare to the tip jar.
Two espressos for the man in brown!
Two espressos for the man in brown!
You might want to write this down. I got a lot of thirsty ad execs who need their caffeine fix. Okay, I need a large latte with light foam. I need French roast, a plain, French roast.
Enough already.
I'm not done yet.
Yeah, you are, okay? I'm gonna give you the manager special, and you'll just take it, okay? One manager special.
One manager special.
What's the manager special?
Take these.
This isn't what I ordered.
Take the goddamned drinks, asshole.
Excuse me, Mr. Puck.
What, Mr. Manager?
I'm tired. Let's go home.
We don't have a home.
What about Sam?
Can't go back there.
What are we gonna do? Where will we sleep?
You ever been camping?
Good night, David Dwight.
Good night, John boy. I always wanted to say that.
The thing is that when nothing means anything, everything is equal. Men are the same as women, Ford is as good as Chevy, apples are equal to oranges. But friendship always equals sacrifice. Our time in the wilderness had come to an end.
Sure is great to have you back.
Much changed?
Same old, same old.
What about Johnny Black?
Not the same old, same old?
Well, he's the same. Just his bag of tricks have changed.
Now is the time for direct action.
We have to act to save the children. Southwestern Petrochemicals is the Metroplex's largest producer of fluorocarbons. The children don't just have to breathe their pollutants, but they are brought up to be accustomed to their bogus techno wonders and the magic they promise. Yeah. Yeah.
And how are we gonna take direct action?
Protest. Organize the workers. And if we have to, chain ourselves to the front gates.
And just let them go out the back?
What are you proposing?
I'm saying we shut them down.
That's what we're saying, if you'd listen.
No. I'm saying we really shut them down. What was in the bag?
Simtex.
Simtex?
Simtex.
What's Simtex?
Plastic explosives.
The checks turned it out like tapioca during the Cold War.
And what did he propose doing with it?
What do you think? And what do you propose we do with that?
What do you think?
A book? What kind of book?
I like books.
We all like books. But there is one book that goes against everything that we stand for. I won't carry it. I won't tell anyone where to get it. And I won't even discuss it.
The Bible?
Jesus.
What's this book?
The Anarchist's Cookbook. It's a relic from the past. We put it together back in the old days, back in the 60s. It taught you how to make bombs, how to make drugs. And it meant something once. But today, even the author is trying to take it out of circulation.
Can't people still get it online?
Oh, shit. You can get the atomic bomb online. Oh, but that kind of thinking, that kind of stuff, no. You don't want to go down that road. You do not want to get involved. The book's not the problem. The problem is the kind of people that look to it for answers. It's the first step, if not the last step, down the slippery slope.
The slippery slope to what?
Look, so long as you play by their soft as a baby's bottom rules, you're gonna get soft as a baby's bottom results. All right, you just have to decide how far you're willing to go.
None of us supports violence.
Nor do I. But we're not the violent ones. Was it anarchists who decided to cut down the rainforest? No. Did we invent the slave trade, the drug trade, or international trade? No. The violence, it's not part of the system, it is the system. We're just fighting against it. Okay, and until we're ready to accept that fact, no one will take us seriously.
No, Johnny. You're the one that no one will take seriously.
Don't you ever fucking say that to me. Because you will take me seriously.
So no one took him seriously.
Not seriously enough.
So you agree with Johnny Black now?
I just think he's got a point, that's all.
One day, Puck, you'll see. It's something you've started will get away from you. All your shits and giggles will turn to death and destruction, and there's nothing you can do about it. We will shut down Southwest Chemicals, and it'll be on the front page of every newspaper in America. In Sweden, industrial pollutants would be treated as they should. They would be dealt with politically.
For committing the treasonous offense, not of leading Sam, but of daring to come back, you must now face your fate. You're responsible for the troll education for a month.
Hey, kids, Ziggy Bam Bam, listen. Do you know that in Sweden, they whip kids who disrespect their teachers? Stop it!
Around Sam, the trolls were more desperate, their kids more wild, and Johnny Black was quietly biding his time.
Hanging out.
He didn't have to be Oprah to see that Jay Black was pissed at Jay Red, and that Jay Black would eventually get his revenge.
We're gonna twist these up, okay? Just so you can fit him down through the hole and get him into the gasoline.
Academy Award Best Movie, 1969.
69? Should have been Butch Cassidy and Sundance Kid.
14 letters, and don't tell me what it should have been.
Butch Cassidy's a classic. And it was the first overtly homoerotic mainstream movie.
You're not helping.
Isn't that, like, the best movie ever?
Excuse me. Which movie would you rather see, Butch Cassidy and Sundance Kid or Z?
Butch Cassidy.
Thank you.
Z won Best Picture?
That pretentious piece of art house shit. And since when is Z spelled with 14 letters?
Excuse me, sir.
What won Best Picture in 1969?
Midnight Cowboy.
Thank you.
But it should have been Butch Cassidy.
What the fuck do you want?
Can we speak to your manager?
This is an anarchist collective, okay? There is no manager. We don't believe in hierarchical leadership. You little fuck shits.
Don't worry about it.
You want to wash the counter?
Yeah, sure.
Let's go get something to eat.
Johnny.
Be good.
All right, who can tell me where babies come from? Come on, who can tell me where babies come from?
How graphic do you want me to get?
Let's see what you know.
Babies are made when a man inserts his penis into a woman's vagina. If the woman has ovulated recently, the chances of conception are pretty good.
These kids are pretty good.
Of course, that's the traditional manner. Many lesbian couples will use a turkey baster.
Okay. That was good. I know I learned something.
What about you?
What about me what?
Well, Johnny Red has Jen, Karla has whoever she wants, and Double D and Sweeney bring home women all the time. Do you just pleasure yourself all the time or what?
What about me? Even a believer in nothing can't deny the intrinsic nature of one's animal self.
Thanks.
Drinking for two tonight?
One for me, one for the sexy freak I've been chatting up for over 15 glorious minutes.
Good for you. It's time Puck got a fuck.
That's right, it is. It is good for me.
Who is she? You're kidding.
What, too good for me?
Too gay for you. I fucked her a month ago.
What?
Look and learn, Pucky boy.
Can I buy you a drink?
No.
Can I buy you two drinks? Fuck.
What are you doing?
Making conversation, initiating human flirtation rituals. It's all the rage in Europe.
I knew my days were numbered. I knew that if I didn't get off sometime soon, I would explode in a fiery ball of blood, spunk, and tears.
Property is theft. Deeds are propaganda. Only love and sex are commodities.
I'm sorry if I didn't make a good impression.
Oh, let me freshen up, love.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. The pleasure of lovemaking with gin is often augmented by thoughts of small children, boys usually.
What is that?
Come the revolution, our bourgeois notions of sexuality will not inhibit expressions of love between a man and a child.
Give me that.
Take it, you sick fuck.
you get out of the car?
Hey, back up, you fuck! And what is this shit?
Quit fighting.
Get up against the car.
Put your hands behind your back.
You're under arrest.
For what?
Violation of Texas Criminal Code B11873, engagement in a lewd and unlawfully criminal sex act. Oral sex and homosexuality are illegal in this state, ma'am.
You're busting me for eating pussy?
Jesus.
Up from our nap, are we? Jody doesn't like her boys running around without permission. Are you always such an unruly boy?
Listen, I've never had much luck with the ladies, you know, and I mean, it's not like I'm fugly, right? I mean, I'm not bad to look at, but I just always seem to find a way to,
oh, yeah,
you know, kind of screw it up. So if you want to just forget this... What are you doing?
Q&A time is over, unruly boy. No talking. Shh. Does the unruly one have something he wants to say?
Please be nice.
Morning. Good morning, unruly one. Wake up. We're gonna miss breakfast. Morning, ladies. Hey, y'all.
Hey, Jody. Good morning.
I want you all to meet my new boyfriend, Peter.
Hi, Peter.
Puck.
Huh?
Puck. Peter is the name of someone who buys into the system. Puck is an outsider, a man in the lamp.
Well, his driver's license said Peter. He's very unruly. Say goodbye to Peter, y'all.
Bye, Peter.
Come on, I've got class in 30 minutes.
What is this, a sorority?
You're kidding, right? Oh, Peter.
Puck. Listen, I've just got to ask, if only for personal hygienic reasons. Are you on heroin?
What?
I saw your rig.
Oh, that. Well, I hitchhiked at clubs, like the one last night, and when I do get a ride, the first thing I do is tell them I'm HIV positive and offer them a hit. Keeps the unruly rapists away.
Couldn't you just drive?
This car?
Guess not. Look, listen, you know how I was telling you about me and luck and the ladies? Well, I just want you to know that I would understand if you didn't want to see me again. I mean, I'm not very good at the whole relationship thing, and I know that...
Puck, listen, you're a nice guy. A really nice guy, and I'm not used to that. I'll call you.
I don't have a phone! Hello?
Thank you.
don't know if you noticed, but some things have kind of changed around here.
Oh, geez, now that you mention it.
Yeah, Jin left Johnny Red. Sweeney got a warning from the Japanese government. Nobody wanted an international incident on their hands. Karla got a warning from a judge who didn't want an international incident on his hands. And the troll kids, huh? Yeah, they moved on.
The only person who hadn't been affected was Johnny Black. He now had the run of Sam. And I was the only one who seemed to notice.
Hey, give me that remote.
Look, you guys gotta realize these kind of setbacks are bound to happen. Can't let it get you down.
Well, what are you supposed to do now?
Fly the friendly skies.
Oh, sorry. I'll take care of this as soon as y'all ready. Hey, what's that mean?
What?
Your shirt, censorship is anti-American. What's it mean?
Censorship is when the government tells people what they can or can't do or say.
Like what?
Well, like if the government were to tell you that you couldn't advertise your special Meal on Wheels deals.
The government never did that.
Right, but if they did, then that would be censorship.
And that's not American?
That's right.
So it's European?
No.
Yes, it is European.
That's what I thought.
It's so not European. Did you know that Sweden has enshrined the freedom of speech into their country?
You always talk about Sweden like it's so fucking great. Let me ask you, do they have girls on roller skates serving hamburgers and chili fries in Sweden?
It was the smartest thing Double D ever said.
Let's blow this hamburger stand.
That's great. Because this is a hamburger stand and people are always saying
that. We got it.
All right, so that's it then? I run the show from now on? Johnny?
Have it your way.
You know the old saying, it's Sinatra's world, we just live in it?
Yeah.
That was us. Only it wasn't Frank Sinatra's world. It was Johnny Black's. And we were living in it.
Come back here, you turkey bananas!
Prologue. Introduction. Word of advice. The essence of anarchy is alacrity. Anarchists must beware and be aware at all times. This is best accomplished synthetically.
Christmas in April.
Idiot.
Cool.
Chapter 1, Direct Action. Confront the people where they live. Make the ordinary extraordinary. Make the extraordinary ordinary.
All right. You want to say to the viewers back at home, fuck?
Well, first of all, I just want to give a shout out to the big man
shout
upstairs,
out,
and you know, I just want to say that I went out there, I gave 110%. You know, I didn't want to force it, didn't want to try and do too much, just want to let the game come to me. You know, but the bottom line is that I got to be concerned with what the puckster is doing, because if the puckster is out there doing what the puckster is capable of doing. I think you gotta like our chances.
All right, how far are you willing to go?
As far as it takes. This is your wake-up call, America. Join us, now. Not yesterday, today. Sooner, not later. This is not some pie-in-the-sky, quixotic quest. The global markets are devouring your future.
How's that?
Quixotic, huh? That's a pretty big word for a kid who grew up on the lam.
This is not some pie-in-the-sky, quixotic quest. The global markets are devouring your future.
Use the master's tools to dismantle the master's house. If you act like you're in charge, you'll be treated like you're in charge.
We're with JCN.
All right, now for the moment we've all been waiting.
Number of hits since establishing website, 3,515.
Oh. Wow, that is
3 million what?
3 million hits, we're part of something huge. Over 3 million hits. Do you understand the scope of this movement?
George W. Bush received over 49 million votes. Do you understand the scope of this movement?
Oh, please. Global anarchy is the vanguard of the people against the policies of big business and big government to liberate the foundations of human consciousness and personal freedoms.
Same here.
Anarchists support all expressions of individual responsibility and personal freedoms.
Same as Republicans.
Well, we think that the government has no place in your uterus.
I hate you. Unlock me before we miss breakfast.
You know what I'm saying? I like that. It kind of makes me feel dirty.
Howdy, boys. How y'all faring today?
Good.
Good.
Well.
Well?
We're faring good and well, sir.
What you fellas got in them boxes?
Well, that would depend on which box you're referring to, sir.
Stuff, sir.
You don't mind if I have a look? What's this all about?
It's a science kit for the orphans down at St. Jack's.
Yeah, for the orphans.
You fellas wouldn't by chance be anarchists.
We're Mormons.
This is where the orphans live?
Yeah, can you believe it?
Poor bastards.
Well, you all have a Merry Christmas.
And to you, Happy Kwanzaa.
For the orphans.
You should come visit them sometime.
You know what? I think I will.
No mas.
For the Honorable Justice William Haverford.
Be seated. I see from your records that you were summarily dismissed from MIT after using their computers to access credit card numbers and then using those numbers to buy rainforest land for preservation. That's a very noble, if illegal, thing to do. I sentence you to 3 years in a medium-level security facility. It is time you learn the value of hard work. Your propensity toward deviancy and criminality worries me. And as for you, I'm sending you somewhere more severe than prison and more unforgiving than any chain gang.
Now, son, that there bracelet you got on your ankle will let us know where you are at all times. If you venture more than 30 feet from the perimeter of this house, it will activate the alarm and you will go to jail. If it gets wet, it will activate the alarm and you will go to jail. If it gets broke or senses a change in body temperature, it will activate the alarm and you will go to jail. If you need to get somewhere, give me a jingle. I can get you an escort. Hopefully in 180 days, you will have learned something from this experience.
Oh my God, look at what the cat dragged in. You barely touched your green beans.
I don't like green beans.
I've soaked them with brown sugar.
I don't like green beans.
I thought you liked green beans soaked with brown sugar.
No, Mother.
Are you sure?
He said he doesn't like green beans. He doesn't like green beans.
Not even with brown sugar.
Not even with brown sugar.
You're probably wondering about my brother who made millions in his high-tech company's IPO. Well, there was no IPO. There was no high-tech company, and there is no brother. Okay? So, I lied.
You know, Susie's gone religious.
Well, isn't that good for Susie?
Hannah.
Hannah's religious, too.
I changed my name to Hannah.
Oh, that's right. I don't know anybody named Hannah.
It means merciful.
Does it also mean hypocritical, manipulative witch with an illegitimate child who thinks that she can change her name and thereby change her past in life?
Go fuck yourself, Puck!
Now, is that merciful behavior?
Stop it. Will you please? Will you do something?
You want to play golf tomorrow, son? Like them clubs? Those beauties have been waiting for you for 5 years.
Is that right?
Son?
I think I'll shoot again. I hate this game.
Yeah, it means you should play more.
No, it means I hate this game.
Well, I know I like to come out here before dawn. But while the sun's coming up, hey, it's a game for individuals. People want to clear their heads.
In my head, I could hear Johnny Red rail against the idle class. Johnny Black would say my dad was under false consciousness. But looking at him on that golf course, I'd never seen a happier man. And wasn't that what it was about? Just a man, a few sticks, a ball, a hole? What was wrong with that?
What do you say we play the back nine?
Peter was always part of something. This is when he was on the junior quiz bowl team, and this is for when he was on the debate squad. They called themselves the master debaters.
what's this right here?
I'm not sure what that one is. That's for the school service society.
Oh. The school service society.
Yeah, well, Peter just always liked to be involved in everything. He liked to be part of a group, you know, something big.
Oh, is that right, Peter?
Why don't we go out to dinner?
Try the yogurt covered pretzel?
Yogurt covered raisins.
Excellent choice for a novice.
I want a yogurt pretzel.
Roland, how many times do I have to tell you? No means no. Come on.
I want one.
Shh. I know you like kids.
I love kids. Not like Johnny Red, but I love them.
What are you doing? I mean, what if everyone were as unruly as you?
I mean, I'll be free.
Can I get that on a bumper sticker? I mean, don't you ever want to do anything worthwhile? Like, have you ever thought about going to college?
I went to college. I dropped out.
Why?
I have my reasons.
Well, don't you ever wonder about your future?
Future's for people who don't have a present.
Bumper sticker.
You don't understand alternative lifestyles. Besides, I have friends.
Oh, really? Huh. Your friends are currently doing community service counseling drug acts in order to have a steady supply. The city finally shut down your flop house, and things are only going to get better when your best friend, Johnny Black, gets out on parole in a couple weeks. Look, I care about you. I do. Probably more than I should. And I want you to be all you can be without having to join the army or the quiz bowl team or the master debaters. Do you ever go to New York and you see those freaky guys on the street who paint part-time and sell books and run marathons?
I've been to New York City, okay?
Well, that should be you.
I mean, those guys really do their own thing.
Right. Advice from the oldest cliche in the book, a whip-toting, Gestapo boot-wearing cultural conservative. Republican by day, sadomasochistic dominatrix by night. I'm sorry.
That's pretty pathetic, huh?
No, it's actually one of the more endearing cliches still around. That and the hooker with a heart of gold. Look, I lied. I've never been to New York City. I've never even been out of Dallas.
Well, then I think it's time you left.
Doing a real good job, Peter.
Thank you, sir. Please pass on the good word to my parole officer.
It was all good, real good. I was still under house arrest, but at least the place was mine. I was working 60-hour weeks. I was earning 10 cents above minimum wage. I had a place to go, a place to call my own, and the government provided all the dolphin-safe tuna I could eat.
Hey, you mind if I work in with you?
I was making new friends, living the life of suburban bliss, and loving every minute of it. What could possibly go wrong?
Mail call.
Dear Peter, I hope this letter finds you well. Don't repeat this, but I think I might just miss you. Your good old friend Johnny Black was released on parole, and within days, there was a number of cyber disturbances around town. Texas Petrochemicals had a change of heart regarding fluorocarbon production after a virus hit their computers. ATM machines started to dispense extra cash to customers. And Johnny Black's Anarchy in the USA manifesto appeared on the homepage of all the local elementary schools.
You want to see me?
Yes, yes. Are you having fun at the party?
Very much, sir.
Good, good. Well, what do you think you're doing, having this little birthday party for yourself? I happen to know it's not your birthday.
I know you know that. Or at least I figured that you'd figure that out. It's just that Carolyn's dog died, and she's been miserable for a week. I just thought a party might cheer her up. Just wanted to make a difference around here, sir.
Officer Rogers said you were an anarchist.
Sure.
Is that what anarchists do? Take matters into their own hands? Every person responsible for themselves?
More or less.
Sounds good to me. I want you to go back out there and enjoy the party.
Some rest.
Myself to a can of tuna. Hope that's not a problem for you.
Not a problem at all.
Dear Jody, stop. I've got a problem living in my government-subsidized apartment. Stop. Its name is Johnny Black. Stop. Am considering calling police and turning in said piece of shit fuck-all fuckwad. Stop. What should I do? Stop.
Mail sent.
Hey, we're gonna go get a drink up the street. You wanna come with?
Oh, I'm just waiting for an email. I'll meet you all down there.
You're home late.
Had some extra work around the office. How are you?
Pretty good for a piece of shit fuck-all fuckwad. Yeah, you really shouldn't send email in an open transport system, such as that one at work.
I knew I should have just turned around and run. I knew I should have already called the cops. I knew I shoulda, woulda, coulda, but I didn't.
You know, we really missed you around, Sam.
And just like that, I was back in.
Come on, we're almost there. Just a few more millimeters. You're probably worried about the blood. It's totally natural. I don't know about this much, but it's natural. Don't worry about it. It's so close. Just hang on, man. We're almost there, all right? Forget about your security deposit. There we go. How was that? How was that?
Not so bad.
Atta boy. Disabled American veteran.
I'm with him. I should probably play the victim and say I was forced against my will. I should tell you that he patty-hearsted me back into the group. But that's bullshit. I was back because I wanted to be. Sam was gone, but we soon found a new home. We called it Son of Sam.
Mi casa, su casa, puck. That's just the rats.
So what do you think?
I like it.
Yeah, you mean it?
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Yeah, it has a lot more character than Sam, don't you think?
There had been a revolution while I was away.
Find something, a particular artist?
Where's Double D and Sweeney?
Never heard of them. Are they old school, new school, R&B, or hip-hop?
I've got some new recruits!
What's going on here?
It doesn't all come for free, Puck. Look, think of it as community service. They need chemical enhancement, we've got it. I'd rather they get it from us than somewhere else.
It's not chemical enhancement. It's drugs. And that's not what we're about.
I agree with you. We're not about drugs. Okay, this is a means to an end. Come on, you know that.
Johnny Black has made this place work like you wouldn't believe.
Hey, face it, there's been a revolution while you're away.
Johnny Black was right. There had been a revolution. We were all nihilists now. I see you don't get out much anymore. You know he's dealing drugs here?
What about Sweeney? I went to the record store. All his records are gone. Place is under new management. No one's even heard of him.
He keeps D company.
You know where D is? Where is he? Where's D?
He's our guardian angel. He watches over us.
Close the door. Close it. Close it.
What's going on?
Did you know that Karla and Johnny Red never fuck? They sleep together every night, but they don't have intercourse.
That's interesting.
I thought so. I've seen that girl have sex with Johnny Black. Karla, too.
Karla's seen them have sex?
No. Karla has sex with Johnny Black, and then he gives her candy.
Where's Sweeney? Okay.
Come here, man. Got some people I want you to meet. This is Ronnie, Milo, and Buck, Aryan People's Party. It's Buck here. It's Big John, Billy Bob, and Travis, Texan Nation. This is Dale and...
Rich.
Rich, exactly.
How you doing?
These guys are with North American Fighting Tacticians Association, NAFTA.
What's going on here?
A meeting of the minds, you know? That's what I like to call outreach. Just trying to focus on the positive here, kid. You know, the things we all got in common.
Johnny's bridge builder. Shit, son, we've been squabbling so long we neglected to see where our real interests lay. We got a lot of common ground to cover.
This is the organizational cross-pollination that I've been working at for years.
I like you. I do, I like you.
Can we talk?
What the fuck is that all about?
What do you mean?
You got the Adolf Hitler fan club, North Texas chapter, and every other right-wing gun nut under the sun sitting in our living room.
Yeah, I told you, this is outreach.
I can't believe it either. Johnny Black has finally pulled it all together. Instead of fighting each other, we're fighting together.
Fighting what?
The New World Order, of course.
Are you kidding me? They are the New World Order. There are very few things in this world worse than the United States federal government, and all of them are sitting in my living room.
It's not your living room. It's our living room, and you've heard me say in Sweden they're putting their...
Jesus, Johnny, please. Why did you bring these people here?
I didn't. They came to us.
The website has brought in all sorts of new people. And a lot of them are attracted because of what... you said on the video.
It was like your parents saying they got divorced because of something you did.
There's a place where all ideologies, when taken to their extremes, start to merge. You may not think it right now, but we have everything in common with those guys in there.
What do we have that they would want?
Gentlemen, this is not just a cookbook, and it's not just a plan of action. This is a book of ideas. Around here, that's our Bible.
Cool.
This book is not the answer, but us together here, we are.
So what now?
Time for basic training. Welcome, one and all. Thanks for making the trek.
Come on, meet everyone.
Well, good to see you. It's a nice place you got here.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
I never claimed to be a great judge of character, but something told me, under different circumstances, these guys would be plucking the banjo and making me squeal like a pig.
It's very impressive, Dale.
What, did you raid an army base?
All legally acquired, thank you very much.
Where are you headed, smartass?
Get some water, thank you very much.
You know, I got two lists, and you're at the top of one of them.
This is the last stand of old growth live oaks in northern Texas. And unless we take direct action, university's gonna cut them down. But if we use these, they got no choice but to call off the harvest. If a logger tries to cut in a tree with one of these bad boys in it, it's gonna ruin the saw, and chances are the logger too.
Sounds good to me.
Count me in.
Sounds like bullshit. Our number one concern isn't the fucking oak trees. It should be purifying America.
Okay. But if we purify the country, there's no trees, the environment's all gone to shit, then what's the point?
This country used to mean something, man. But your head's so far up your ass that you can't see that. And you can't see the value of that. You care more about the trees than you do the fate of the state?
The fate of the trees is the fate of the state.
Now that's a joke if I ever heard one. It's no wonder no one here takes you serious.
You would fucking listen to me for 1 second. You would realize that what I'm suggesting here is a multi-pronged approach where everybody gets a piece of what they want. You understand? You understand?
I think he gets the point.
Do you fucking understand?
And that's the way we decided our first joint mission against the local college. The Nazis were gonna burn down the Malcolm X Black Student Union building, the militiamen would blow up the federal loan offices, and we'd spike the trees in the live oak grove.
Where you headed?
Get some air.
I think I'll come with you. Don't tell me you're getting cold feet.
I was living in Sam way before you got there.
But what were you doing? I mean, sure, you're getting free food, you're living off the fat of the land, but really, what did you do? Whose minds did you change? What institutions were affected by you? Who'd you save? Where are all the people you helped, the pieces of land you preserved?
We had fun.
I know. You're the Marx Brothers.
And now we're the Unabomber.
You're like a sorority house with nightly pillow fights, man. Or should I not mention college to the straight-A student who decided to major in suicide his freshman year? I know college was a lonely place for a guy who's always been a part of something, you know? The school service society, the junior quiz bowl, master debaters. In this world, there are doers and there are joiners. And you, my friend, have always been a joiner. Don't even think about it. They're not your friends.
My only friend is strung out in the attic back there.
And he'll stay that way until we finish this mission.
What mission? Nobody ever said anything about hurting people or spiking trees or blowing up buildings.
Yeah, I asked you a long time ago how far you were willing to go. If we don't do this, trees will die. Birds will die. Entire ecosystems will die. If you're not along with us, Puck, you will, too.
You gotta get out of there.
Go where?
Anywhere. I mean, you're dead if you stay there.
And I'm dead if I leave. Johnny Black can find me. He found me when I was in house arrest. He can intercept email. He's got everyone hooked on something, and the rats spy on everything from the attic.
Well, come with me. I'm interning at the Reagan Library this summer.
Of all our senile presidents, he was my favorite.
Well, you can't stay there.
And I can't leave either. Check this out.
What are you gonna do?
Take care of D.
Can't you call his parents?
He doesn't have parents. He has me.
Are they making bombs? Are you kidding?
They're Christmas ornaments.
It's the end of the line. I need more nails.
I'll get some.
I'll go with them.
You don't like me, do you?
What would make you say a thing like that?
What the fuck are you doing?
Fuck. You failed the test.
Is that you?
No, man.
It's me.
You guys look like you're having fun down there making those ornaments. Dee and I were joining, but he's sleeping, and he got into Johnny Black's cookie jar. And...
Oh, the cookie jar?
Yeah. They were bad cookies, too.
It wasn't supposed to be like this. We just wanted to make the world a better place to live. Not this.
Show me these cookies. They're in the box.
What the hell? What is all this? Flapjacks?
Better than flapjacks. I call them puckjacks.
Not bad.
All right.
Eat up, fellas. Nobody ever kicked ass in an empty stomach, right?
No syrup there? And molasses. All right.
What's going on?
Flapjacks.
Whoa. Pupjacks.
And don't eat too much, fellas. We don't want you to get bloated for the mission tonight.
What the fuck are you doing, man?
Made some grub for the troops. You don't want some?
No, I don't want some.
Try it. You like it.
What is all this shit?
I told you, they're puckjacks. Don't you want some hot off the griddle?
Get...
Hit me! Hit me, fuck! Hit me!
What the fuck? What is this? Hey, don't eat the...
Mind if I have a turn?
Be my guest. What now?
Well, I was thinking taking that vacation I always wanted. Maybe take her along with me. Did you know that in Sweden they offer a free substance abuse treatment program? What about you?
What about me? I was dead if I stayed, and I was dead if I left. I was dead if I went to my family, and I was dead if I went to Jody. There was no place I could go. No place but one.
Look, I realize I'm no saint in all this, but I'm hardly a sinner, relatively speaking. Cape's about to run out. Aren't you gonna do something?
Why are you telling us this? You realize you're incriminating yourself.
In this world, there are joiners and there are doers. I happen to be a doer. What are you?
611-28. Hey, don't I get to make a phone call?
Mrs. Cox, will you give him the phone, please? What number? What number Mrs. Cox will dial for you?
Never mind. Thank you, Mrs. Cox.
Well?
Well.
Would you like the money wired to an account, or would you prefer a cashier's check?
Which money is that?
For information leading to the arrest of Dale Hopkins, we have been authorized to pay you $75,000. And for information leading to the arrest of Jonathan Blue, a.k.a. Johnny Black, the Bureau is rewarding you with $125,000. These tax-free rewards total $200,000.
Okay, so I'm a narc, and I'm an asshole. But I was now a moderately successful narc and asshole worth 200 grand. I had no friends, no direction in life, no ambition, and no job experience. I'd never been alone, and I'd never been out of Dallas.
Mom,
Dad, Anna.
Wherever you're going.
What's your name?
Puck. Peter.
Well, what is it? Puck or Peter?
What was it? Post-apocalyptic Puck or pre-productive member of society Peter? I had to choose, and whatever I decided was going to...
I said, what's your name, son?
Peter. Peter Puck.
Sounds like Peter Pan. Boy who never grew up.
No, that would be Johnny Black.
So where you headed?
Me?
Yeah, I don't see nobody else up here in the cab.
California. I'm gonna go have an internship at the Reagan Library. My girlfriend's gonna go back to school, or vice versa.
You got a pretty mouth on you. I said you got a pretty mouth on you.
You want a hit? I know some people get freaks sharing with HIV positives, but I don't give a shit if you don't.
No. Thank you, but, no thanks.
There is no path in life that is open to all Americans. The idea of a path is like the idea of a billionaire brother. Or the idea that you can have complete freedom without responsibility. Freedom without responsibility. That's a lie. A piece of bullshit to string you along. But maybe there are paths. Plural, multiple, numerous paths in many, many directions. And no two paths are the same. Kind of like snowflakes. Or fingerprints. Or roads that can take you out of your hometown.
Let's walk down the glassy top. down the ridge to the mill.